Actually, we just burn one, it's about 10 billion. We burn 10, that's about the budget needed to save of the whole Singapore. What so that's quite enough, actually, yeah. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Tizanglin. So people usually call me Venerable Yo Wei. I'm the abbot of Tizanglin, and I'm also sitting on the board of the Singapore Buddhist Federation. I'm doing educations there. Wow, sensitive question. There are several kinds of joss paper. Again, this is a Chinese kind of thing. There is a type where they scatter on the tombstone. So these are like in replacement of real money. In ancient China, there was a time where shells were treated as currency. So they scatter these shells on the tombstone to show how affluent or how filial the family is. So now, they instead of putting shells, they put paper, colored papers. Another kind of joss paper which they scatter is during funerals. So they'll scatter the paper offerings so that spirits around the vicinity would not disturb the passage or the journey of the deceased. For 7 months, they do all the offerings along the side of the pathway and things like that. So if people were to remove this and then they'll have bad karma or they'll fall sick or the ghost will come and haunt them, then the first person to die will be our essential cleaners. Right? They'll be the first one to to get it from the spirits. So essentially Noah. Once offering is done, you can just clear the offering. Joss paper and hell note, depending on who they are offering to. Joss paper, especially the ones with the gold leaf, so that's essentially usually for deity. And hell bank notes are usually for the deceased. Actually, we just burn one, it's about 10 billion. We burn 10, that's about the budget needed to save of the whole Singapore. So that's quite enough, actually, yeah. Regardless whether it's in Buddhism or Taoism, we have a mantra. It's something which we chant or pray. So this has a multiplier effect on the offering. So we can offer one orange or one hell bank note, and then we do the mantra, and then we visualize that, you know, this orange, this one orange or this hell bank note can multiply into many, many. See? So that's a better return on investment, I think. There are many different varieties of Buddhists. So for the Mahayana Buddhists, which are essentially the more Chinese Buddhists, they get this burning culture through the Chinese culture. So in ancient China, what we know is that the first burning instance dates back to like the northern or the southern dynasties. And that's the time where the royalties, in order to protect their imperial tomb, they put money offerings in the tombs. This is to ward off also tomb raiders who are coming for jewelry. So instead of putting real jewelry, they put in paper money. In ancient China, whatever the royalty will do, the commoners will follow. There was another very interesting story about a scholar who is selling paper. So in order to make paper sell, he came up with this idea of, you know, offering paper money to the deceased, because the deceased cannot come and dispute that I don't need this money. So that's how it comes about. Essentially, burning paper money is more a Chinese kind of culture. So it's not inherently Buddhist, neither is it inherently Taoist. The only two things which we burn are incense and probably candles in the form as a light offering. Incense will represent virtue. We remind of ourselves virtues that are supposed to permeate from us. In Buddhism, light represents wisdom. So to offer Buddha or deity with a candle offering or light offering also remind us that wisdom is very important. For Buddhists, actually, no. Usually we will do one, regardless of whether it's an offering to the Buddha or is it offering to the deceased, we just use one. Or the Taoist people, they would believe that odd number are supposed to be for the deity or for the more auspicious kind of offering, and even number are supposed to be for the deceased. So usually you see Chinese or Taoist people offering two incense. Yeah, that's for the deceased people. People like to think that when they offer more things, they get more merits. or they get more return. But now we know the more we burn, actually, the more bad things we get. We get more fumes. We destroy more part of the earth. So yeah, so that's the tricky part of it. That being said, I think then there are people who depends on this lah for a livelihood. People who sells incense, who sell joss paper. For everybody's sanity, or for the consolation of most Chinese as well, if they want to burn, sure, do the burning in moderation. I would also advise that more people tune towards the more doing good rather than burning things. Sincerity is more important than whatever we burn.